Ah! I can't even put my feet down because there's so many dead bodies. Hey guys, hope you liked the last video. In the last one, we left home, Lighthouse Cove, Ontario, through Lake St. Clair, down the Detroit River, across Lake Erie to Put-in Bay, and then we sort of hopped from port to port up until about the halfway point of Lake Erie, headed east. We're intending to hit the Erie Canal within a couple of days now. So this morning, we left Erie, Pennsylvania, which was absolutely beautiful. We met some really cool people. That spot is amazing. If you ever have the chance to take a boat across Lake Erie or anywhere in Lake Erie, you have to go to Erie, Pennsylvania. It is by far better than Put-in Bay, any other place we've been. It's just spectacular. The holding is perfect. The protection is perfect. There's so much to do and so much stuff to go see. We had a great time, and there's a lot of cruisers there. There was a lot of sailboats, so that was nice. There were three Canadian boats anchored last night, us and two others. Really cool. Anyway, so now we are about halfway across Lake Erie. Let me show you where we're at here. You can't see land in any direction, which is, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, the first time we have not been able to see land.
Yeah, no, first time.
It's pretty sweet out here. Lake Erie was supposed to be really rough today. We're supposed to have like 10 to 15 knots out of the west. It's been northeast for the last 3 or 4 days, so we've been beating into the northeast. We hung out in Erie, Pennsylvania for an extra day, just because yesterday was brutally out of the northeast. But today was supposed to be west, and what we're getting is sort of a bit of north. Anyway, we're motor sailing. We got the diesel at like 2200 RPM. We got a full jib and a full main, and they're actually powered up. So we're doing 6 and change. I think our average on the day so far has been 6.2, but I've seen it over 7 quite a few times. So 6, 6.5, sometimes 7. We're not making bad time. It's supposed to be an 11-hour trip. We're headed for Port Colborne, which is back in Canada. We were gonna go to Dunkirk, but the weather was so good, and the couple that we met set us up with some of their friends and a place to keep our boat and everything for a couple of days when we get to Port Colborne. So it just made more sense to do this. Also, when you try to get your mast taken down at the beginning of the Erie Canal, it's about $400 because they're charged by the foot, and our mast is just over 50 feet. Port Colborne, not being right at the beginning of Erie Canal, is like $150. So that's going to save us a ton of money. And then we can motor from Port Colborne into Buffalo, which is about 3 hours. And then obviously up to Tonawanda, and then start the Erie Canal in a couple days. It kind of sucks leaving Lake Erie behind us because it's been such a cool place to be. And despite the fact that it's beat us up quite a few times, I'm kind of gonna miss it. So anyway, that's where we're at right now. We'll shoot you some updates when we get into Port Colborne. We should be able to get the mast taken down tomorrow. So that'll be a sad moment. We become a powerboat and we're not a sailboat anymore. So anyway, thanks for watching. You wanna know what sailing Lake Erie is like? Yeah, we've killed, a couple hundred flies apiece. We actually broke the fly swatter, and now we're both using her flip-flops. And, every time you kill one, you find 5 or 6 more. And it's terrible. And we have fly tape up in the companionway hatch, because I keep going in and inside and outside constantly. So both fly tapes are starting to get quite a few flies on them, but we've still killed more manually than anything else. It's terrible.
Ah!
I can't even put my feet down because there's so many dead bodies. Wow. Hey guys, so we left Erie, Pennsylvania at 5:30 this morning under the cover of darkness. And we've been crossing Lake Erie ever since. We're now, we're motor sailing. We're 7.5 knots, running the diesel at about 2200 RPM, like just a general easy run. We're full sail. We're on kind of a beam reach. It's a very wide beam reach, but when you run the diesel, you put some apparent wind into it, and that gives us over 7 knots. Otherwise, we'd be doing like 4.5. There's just no wind on Lake Erie today. It's actually just starting to pick up, and we're just approaching Port Colborne on the Canadian side. Getting ready to get the mast taken down now here in Port Colborne. We got we took the boom off, we got all the shrouds and stays are taken off. Well, the stays are still on, the front, back, and the outers are still on and tight, but we're ready. Hey guys, we are officially leaving the Great Lakes today.
Yeah.
Can't say that I'm sad to see them go. Lake Erie's been rough. Today we have 3 hours of motoring up Lake Erie with the mast down, and we'll arrive at the entrance, the North Channel entrance to the Black Rock Canal, and then we'll start heading up the Black Rock Canal toward Tonawanda. Anyway, so experience on the Great Lakes. I guess just Lake Erie and Lake St. Clair, but experiences, Lake Erie is rough. Don't ever go against the wind, because you'll be against the waves. If you can get a southerly, it's a great day. If you can't, then you can't. We've had a lot of west wind and we've had a lot of northeast wind, and we made it though. Yeah. There's a lot of cool places to stay. We're in Port Colborne right now, back in, on the Canadian side, and that's because we got a good deal on stepping the mast. So otherwise we would have gone to Dunkirk, New York, and then we would have hopped across to Buffalo, same way we're doing now. Except it would have been a farther trip. This is, I think, the closest port to Buffalo is Port Colborne. So it's easy. We're going to do it. It's 6:30 in the morning now. We're just about to leave. I think that's it.
Yeah. I'm still not awake.
All right. Well, we will turn the camera back on when we hit Buffalo. And as we go into the Erie Canal, which, by the way, is free this year because it's the bicentennial of the Erie Canal. So we picked the right time to go. The last bit of Lake Erie, and it is super rolly out here. There's also lake freighters everywhere, but it's kind of unnerving when you're rolling this much. And I know the camera probably won't catch it very well, but and you have a 400 pound mast right above your head. I know we did a good job bolting it down and getting it solid and all that stuff. We got a lot of ratchet straps on it, but still unnerving. Very, very rolly. And we don't have, like, normally we'd put up the main or something in motor sail because it gets a lot less rolly. There probably is enough wind to sail right now too, and it is a southerly, so we would be like a full out reach under full sail, so we'd be actually quite comfortable right now, but we're not. So anyway, we've got a few things to do. There's a big point right there with a what's supposed to be a really nice lighthouse on it. We have to give it a couple miles of clearance though, because I guess it's you don't want to be too far inland. Anyway, so we're going to go around that, and then we're going to turn left a little bit and maybe put some of these rollers onto our stern, get a little bit more comfortable, I hope. And then it's a straight shot into Buffalo. Another, I don't know, probably hour and a half after the point, we'll be headed straight, or we'll be pulling into Buffalo. And I don't think we're going to make landfall in Buffalo. I think we're just going to shoot straight up the Black Rock and go for Tonawanda. Hey, babe.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Pretty nervous right now.
Yeah.
Big rollers. Seem big anyways, because yeah, like you said, you don't have the sails up to counteract that. And yeah, so I'm just watching the sun come up because it's settling a little bit. Very scary. Cameras never do it justice. It's beautiful.
So we are rocking and rolling into the Lake Erie Eastern Basin. We are approaching the end of Lake Erie officially, and for us, the end of the Great Lakes. And I guess pretty close to the end of pure fresh water, because after the Erie Canal, it goes to brackish water. I'll give you guys a little shot here. We got the Canadian side behind me. And then Buffalo is right in front of us. looks like the Erie Basin Marina is right in front of us. And I do see some sailboat masts, so I know we'll have enough water. My concern right now is I'd like to grab some diesel. We're about half a tank right now. And I hear it does get a little bit hard to find as you sort of go, which seems weird for such a boaty place. But anyway, we're gonna pop in here real quick, see if we can fill the diesel tank. And if we can, we're gonna check in with US Customs because we're officially landing in New York for the first time. So we gotta do that. We use the Roam app. It's pretty good. And then we'll check all of our oils. We'll do some routine checks of everything. Probably check the sea strainer too. And then maybe half hour here, and then we are going to head up toward Tonawanda. So we're just leaving the Erie Basin Marina, which does have diesel. We got filled up. We took on 7 gallons, which isn't a lot, but we don't burn very much. Anyway, the Buffalo Harbor is behind us, out to port side. And ahead of us is the Black Rock Canal. Sweet. We will turn the camera back on when we see something interesting. Just doing our traditional US Customs check-in with the Roam app. So you log in and you have to enter all your info at first, like you take pictures of your passports and that's the first time you ever use it. But we've already done that, so it remembers who we are. It has our passports associated with it and it knows the boat because we put in all the boat details. And really it just says, where are you landing? And it knows we're in New York, so I had to type Buffalo. It asks if you have more than $10,000, if you have any produce, or if you have any commercial goods. So you answer no to all those, if it's a no, and you hit submit, and then it just says your arrival has been submitted and is awaiting review by a CBP officer. And that's the Customs and Border Protection dudes. And most of them are super cool. We've had like a few laughs and some jokes with some of them, and it's a good time. So it's not really difficult. It's not something to really worry about. We've been in and out of the US for the last 10 days. And the only downside to it is you're not supposed to use it if you're hopping from US port to US port. I'm not sure why. Oh, my arrival is being processed now by a CBP officer. Please stand by for a video interview or confirmation. Most of the time, they jump right to confirmation and it just says, welcome to the US. Here's your clearance number and that's that. But sometimes they do video chat you. So at this point, we're waiting and it'll just ring if it's ready. So.
Right.
Starting to notice that.
As long as you're from where you are now until you get south of Poughkeepsie on the Hudson.
Uh-huh.
So that, I don't know if you know where Poughkeepsie is, it's just south of Albany, New York.
Yep.
You will be, I can give you the number to call if you want to just call us.
Okay.
It's complicated. They don't want us to use the Roam app. Some of them tell you use the Roam app. And then some of the other ones, like the lady we're talking to now in New York, is saying, no, don't use the Roam app. Because you have a cruising license, you just give us a phone call, tell us your cruising license number, and we'll check you into wherever you happen to be. So it is like everywhere you go, every single port, and every time you check in is a little bit different. Some of them don't care that we have a cruising license. They're like, no, you're just checking in, that's that, use the Roam app. And then some of them are like, no, as long as you're the guy in Pennsylvania said, don't use the Roam app in Pennsylvania at all, which was weird. So it's a bit confusing, but we're coming up to the Peace Bridge, so I'll give you a shot. So it's the Canadian side to port and the American side to starboard.
Yeah, we just left Port Colborne.
Okay. Alright, so I have you all checked in for your cruising permit.
Okay.
Now let me go back. So I can give you, I see you requested a local boater option verified traveler number today. Whether it was an accident, a lot of people do it on an accident, which is okay. I will approve that. It's basically called your BR number.
Okay.
It won't, I guess, be necessary for the rest of your cruising permit. However, in the future, it'll make it easier to cross.
Okay, a little shove. Okay, we are just coming into Lockport now. A lot of bridges. We're not sure what to expect. We don't know where the locks are. There's no signs yet. And when we should radio, we understand it's all channel 13 on the VHF, but we don't actually see the locks yet. So we'll just look for signs, I suppose, and we'll do our best and take it really slow. Anyway, cheers. So we just did the first big lock, which is 35 and 34, and it was bloody terrifying. What do you think, babe? She's not thrilled. The hardest part, because there's like ropes that come down the sides, the hardest part is to get the one on the bow, because the bow has the mast sticking out like 10 feet and then the antenna is another 4 feet, so you can't get the bow too close. But at the same time, when she's standing on the bow, she's like 5 feet, half the beam of the boat, so 6 feet from the wall. And she's got the big boat hook. It's like a 7 foot boat hook, but you got to get a rope around the line too, which is really, really complicated without pulling the bow in, because if you do, the mast will hit the wall. So it's, that was terrifying, but we made it. We did the first two, and now, and I think they're the two of the bigger ones, 25 feet apiece. It's not hard going down the lock, it's hard getting onto the wall and grabbing onto the wall properly with a couple of lines. So anyway, we're an hour to the next lock, so this is it.